Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome back to another weather forecast here by Adrian Forecast. And in this video, we're an overall update on the long range and looking at whether the pattern is very favorable for a very cold, snowy central United States for practically after mid January. Well, really watching out for around 2 weeks or so, possibly for active northeast patterns, overall active negative Arctic oscillation patterns. Exactly. As I know, I have not. Quite a while I've been on a break, but hopefully I'm gonna get back to forecasting artists. Well, that first, just go ahead and cast. So first thing I want to go ahead and go look at is the overall type of section. I can give us a better idea what the overall pattern is like for my state. So here's the overall latest forecast for the Arctic Oscillation. So this week is going to be not the we're going to be looking at for the overall this winter pattern, but we are going to be seeing a little bit of a warmer pattern across the United States. I just don't flow for you. Don't expect anything crazy. It'll be rather boring few days for this. But as we go towards now closer to mid January, as we go towards around the 14th, 15th, really after that, we are looking at for this negative Arctic oscillation. So heading into a very strongly positive driven Arctic oscillation, but watch as we get past the 13th, we're gonna be seeing a pretty favorable pretty strong dip into the negative Arctic oscillation. We're seeing negative the overall status. We are going to be staying negative all the way as far as we can go, January 24th. Really overall overall really strong pattern for the Arctic oscillation, polar vortex, and stratospheric vortex. We're going to be seeing a really cool pattern. Overall, me, this thing pretty much negative, very weak negative across this whole pattern. As far as we can, the overall GFS as well is much bit less amplified when it comes negative Arctic oscillation. Here it is. Here's the symbol for best. Negative. It's a negative. And not going to be strong Arctic oscillation. Backward. At a neutral phase. Then we're going to be seeing obviously the PNA coming into here and coming into play. The going to be seeing the NAO come into play. All that stuff coming into play. As we now look at the overall, EO, it also points to a very interesting scenario. So now go back to some EO. We are going to be seeing a positive phase. We are going to be, of course, we are going to be a lot of that, a lot of practical bridging. The Hawaii area and a lot of traffic across portions of the overall the Alaska, all across the North Pacific. Sorry, we're gonna be seeing traffic across that area. But watch as we go very similar time frame around the 14th, that mid January, we're seeing a strong, and I mean a strong dip into a negative EO here. So for those who don't know what a negative EPO is, I'm actually going to kind of explain what a negative EPO pattern is. Practically has to do a lot with the overall Pacific. So with a negative EPO, you're practically going to be seeing really, really, really strong bridging. The negative EPO, you're going to be a really strong bridging across the Alaska Bay Area and then dropping the Pacific. And what that's going to allow is practically for overall Arctic air and Arctic latitude classes south. So as that high pressure kind of polar, that would also translate to positive PNA. So practically want to be negative if you want a rather cold United States that along the British Columbia or Alaska area, and dropping down there in Hawaii, you're a lot of much southern tracks of those storms across the southeast. Of course that would up to the northeast. Overall GFS, very similar. Today is pretty strongly negative, humble, or the mean, constantly going down to the negative. So this is also terrible. This is obviously going to negative phase, like the AO. Let's now look at the overall now Atlantic Oscillation NAO, and this is also going to be pretty strongly positive with the AO. This week, we are going to be seeing a lot of troughing along Brooklyn, along Newfoundland, Georgia, and we are going to see as well that pattern then going to Europe. But watch as from the 15th, the 14th, very worst same day here, 14th, 15th, it goes negative, and it's being negative, and it kind of stays, but at least it's going to stay negative from practically around the 14th, around the 20th. So that's the time frame we're actually watching out for. With the NAO, we're watching out for very, very favorable, pattern for frequent. So basically, one or two days within a week time frame. There's not exact time, not exact dates, but some models are very strong. Some are having a very strong Eastern 19th, and now we have a strong 4th. So there are going to be terrible, but if I'm not buying that long-lived negative NAOs, it's actually going to be still seeing that negative 14th, 15th, 16th, which is watching first NAO, and 17th, 18th, 19th, that second North. Overall, PNA is him, so yeah, it's actually going to be positive. We're actually going to be seeing a positive PNA. Are going to be that ridging pretty far, west, or pretty far east towards of the west. Reasoning why we aren't having a widespread cold air that you see with strong PNA at a 2. We're not, it's moderately strong PNA. Positive DNA. The reason now why we're not going to be seeing anything too this week is because of that EPO, and is because of the NAO is not aligned. Okay, but watch how it's going to be staying positive. Look at that time frame, the 14th, 15th, no presently positive. It's positive around. So that's again, it's going to be 9 days of positive raw GFS, though the GFS has its positive practically for the whole time frame all the way to the 5th, although it kind of gets pretty close to the control phase over here in 2 weeks, but still it's positive across the whole way from 0. So it's definitely, I'd say all these teleconnections all adding up for at least the 14th, 15th, 16th. Pretty strong, but some are also with some of these teleconnections actually favor. It definitely could be a full pattern. Now look at the overall GFS ensemble with a 500-bar high. So overall pattern right now, like are still in a positive PNA. You have that really, really strong troughing, very, very far from Gulf of Alaska. Wow, for this. Across the Western States, why isn't it happening across the United States? So that's actually trophic for strong. But we're gonna kind of see this kind of the as possible. We are gonna still be across the Northeast, that trophic is we actually southwest of strong bridging across the majority of the United States. Areas that far east might be bad week, especially that are closed. Must be not going to be anything too awful. Awful pattern, literally positive, pretty nasty across the west. Let's not go to 14th day, January 14th. Troughing developing. Look how now starting to see that now a negative AO And now we're not going to be anything as possible. Some other. Look by the 16th with the raw pattern with that wrong all across the flask. Now we're going to go. That's going to allow for a much track of southern storms across southeast. That could be one. That could very well yield strong pattern on that trough, which I block it. The pattern, some of if it's favoring ninth, if it's second, strong troughing. Negative EPO, that negative NAO, not so much of this, having a strong Arctic air coming, Arctic starting a very, very weak, a negative that we're bridging all across the Arctic, a very strong negative, other than European, that positive NA there. Negative angles across actually negative digits. I don't think I just logic the overall 14 my friend. There's that dropping across the south, that strong north, 16 strong trough, that and also kind of tell that we're negative AO because Alaska wow, terrible, nice, pretty strong, across the west, positive, then negative, a lot of troughing across the tropic. Throw a pattern. There. So, I mean, it's definitely looking like a pretty terrible area. Large. A little bit for the guys. So, overall, need the 14 day outlook. So, favoring all across north, the overall north. Obviously. Across the best, with 40 different inches, is not gotta be semblance, especially in a last negative huge, clearly, especially as strong over there. So, definitely, I say a pretty favorable pattern. Like I said, is the models. Wrong, nor'easter pattern. I don't minimize my guys. So now look at the overall HDFS. They're gonna be transitioning for the pretty favorable negative AO, negative allowing for possibly very frequent Miller pattern. So nothing, but as we're not getting strong loop crash, but with a decent dropping across off the very, very, very strong loop pressure. And I mean very strong loop pressure. That's why we are watching after the mainly if they verify. I mean, look at that 977 millibars. 970 millibars, but it's not done yet. It goes to 909 millibars, 962 millibars. So there is a chance for some very significant order. Now this track part not broken. So let's go very significant volatile across the coastal and just a few days after that, we see another pattern low pressure off the coast. It isn't again off kind of on the east, another eastern coast pressure now across southeast, the overall and terrible area all across these ports, and as far as we go, model one. As we now go, if now a storm pressure comes across the lakes, goes into the north, also pressure right after that, other very strong pressure going right off the strong 180 the bars. And watch out, we are watching out for another gale type possible. Although this really read on this type of pattern, also I look at the raw you 15th place, a little bit DFS, but the dates are on the location, but look at this, still seeing a massive northeast across the northeast, all the Great Lakes and bars. Watch out for. Right after that, another northeast comes in at 979 millibars. Tell the pattern really, really variable. As well, overall cold, eastern, cold, snowy. At least next week and a half, possibly 2 weeks. More than that, if it does verify as max. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys later.